Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Elliott.
Where are we going today?
Kennedy.
Kennedy Space Center. What's going to happen there today?
Shuttle launch.
And how special is that?
Very.
Very special. So who are we saying goodbye to?
Bye.
Bye. See you later.
Bye.
Bye. Bye, Mummy.
Bye. Have a nice time. I hope you have a
blast. Always the humour. Always the humour.
Susan, Sandra, Daniel and Abby are all staying at home today. We're just chilling out by the pool. But the boys are going to Kennedy Space Center.
And the shuttle launch today, it's Discovery or something it's called. Yeah, Discovery, the shuttle Discovery. And it's supposed to be its last launch ever because NASA are just doing the last few launches. And it just happens to be today out of pure luck. So pretty special, really. So yeah.
Three, here's the mission hatch. STS stands for Space Transportation System. That is the formal name of the space shuttle program. 133 is the mission number. On this mission, Space Shuttle Discovery will deliver a crew of 6 astronauts, along with the permanent multi-purpose module and express logistics carrier number 4 to the International Space Station. The permanent multi-purpose module started out as one of NASA's 3 multi-purpose logistics modules, originally designed to carry cargo to and from the International Space Station, like a shipping container. This module has already flown back and forth to the International Space Station on 7 previous shuttle missions, and has been used to transport vital hardware and supplies to the orbiting outpost. It has been modified to become a permanent station component. So when this goes up in Discovery, it will not come back down like in previous missions. This will become a new station module. Express Logistics Carrier number 4 is an unpressurized platform designed to support external payloads on the outside of the space station. When mounted on the station's truss, Express Logistics Carrier number 4 will provide a platform for deploying experiments and will also serve as a parking fixture for spare components. Think of it as a pallet. That's a good way to look at it. STS-133 will be the 133rd space shuttle mission, NASA's 35th space shuttle mission to the International Space Station, and the final mission for Discovery. Discovery lifted off for the first time on August 30th, 1984. She has flown 38 missions. In April of 1990, Discovery carried up and deployed the Hubble Space Telescope, the first of NASA's 4 great observatories. In October of that same year, Discovery carried up and deployed Ulysses, a spacecraft designed to study the polar regions of the Sun. In October of 98, Discovery carried astronaut John Glenn back into space. John Glenn was one of the original Mercury 7 astronauts. He became the first American to orbit the Earth during Project Mercury in the early 1960s. And Discovery was also used as the return flight vehicle following the Challenger tragedy and the Columbia tragedy. Quite a legacy. Discovery is scheduled to lift off this afternoon at 4:50. She'll deliver her crew of 6, permanent multi-purpose module, and express logistics carrier number 4 to the International Space Station. This mission is scheduled to last 11 days with 2 spacewalks planned to do maintenance and install new components. So again, 4:50 this afternoon. Now, I bet many of you are probably wondering, why 4:50? Why not 4:30 or 5 o'clock or 5:30? Because, ladies and gentlemen, a successful mission begins with a precisely timed launch. A space shuttle has a specific period of time, known as a launch window, each day to launch. A launch window is the period of time within which a space shuttle can be launched to put itself into position to reach the proper orbit to accomplish its mission. Remember, Discovery, crew of 6, will be going to the International Space Station. To rendezvous and eventually dock with the International Space Station, the vehicle has to reach the same orbit as the International Space Station. Now, the space station's orbit is fixed above the Earth, but the Earth is turning below the International Space Station, so their positions relative to each other are constantly changing. In one day, approximately 24 hours, the Earth makes one 360-degree turn, spinning about 15 degrees per hour. The space station orbits the Earth once about every 92 minutes. This means that the space station passes over different areas of the Earth's surface during each of its orbits. So it actually appears from down here that the station moves about 1,500 miles to the west over the course of each of its orbits. But in reality, it's the Earth that's turning underneath the station. The launch must be carefully timed so that Discovery and her crew can successfully chase down the International Space Station. It's the launch window that determines when we fly. It's different for every mission. Liftoff actually occurs after the International Space Station has flown past the launch site and is in front of the space shuttle. So again, 4:50 this afternoon.
Space Center, just in the outer orbit restaurant thing at the moment. We did the simulator launch earlier, which was good fun. It's like, you know, obviously just like you're in a rocket, like taking off in a shell. And we were going to do the tour as well. Obviously the launch is today, so most of the center's actually kind of being closed off at the moment because you don't want people mucking around, you know, getting lost in the area. But it's cool, we've got the big screens up, so you can see the astronauts getting ready now, sitting down in the shuttle, and it'll be a couple more hours yet, but then we'll see it all take off, so it should be pretty cool.
It's 20 minutes to the launch, and we've just had a no-go problem at the moment. So, Not happy.
We knew it was going to go quick though, really, didn't we? Con Dead, how was that?
Really, really good.
Yeah? That's once in a lifetime.
Yeah, worth a life for sure.
Unbelievable.
The noise and the power, you imagine if you were any closer.
I could feel the vibrations in the thing. Yeah. Like on the thing I was sitting on, I could feel the vibrations.
The noise that travelled to us, didn't it?
Yeah.
Right, should we get going?
Cool as it is.
It's a hot one.
Where are we going now, Daddy?
Elliott.
Hooters.
Hooters.
Hooters of NASCAR.
Hooters of NASCAR.